Good morning on Kenosha Today.
Hello again, everybody.
Oh, Harry! Harry! Oh, yeah, Harry!
You know, there comes a time when you probably ought to stop broadcasting. I probably should have quit about 5 years before I passed.
I think we should have quit about 20 years ago.
Unfortunately, they locked the liquor cabinet up before I got there. Well, those business were short.
Somebody said something, Lenny says, I'll get it. He falls off the back of the stage, takes down a couple of the prop trees we got. Yeah. Down goes Lenny. I said, boy, what was in that water? Well, it wasn't water. God love Lenny Kitson.
Get through what you got to get through, Scott. We'll come back around to it.
You know, I was thinking back some of the more notable guests. Dan Trevani, 7-time Emmy Award, and he comes in all dressed up, and he's looking around, and I said, yeah, dude, this is where we operate from. The first words out of his mouth, he goes, no questions about Hill Street Blues. What am I an accountant? What do I know? We only deal in truth here.
Oh, my God. What world am I living in? Scott Barton's making me laugh.
Don't you feel a little stupid?
My Chesapeake model is only 12.5.
extra 2,500 gets you to...
This certainly beats the $9.99 blow-up doll I got in my closet right now.
I think that was like $19.99.
Well, you got the half price discount, didn't you? After my wedding. Was a virgin sacrifice?
Not that I recall. We couldn't find one.
And not in Kenosha anyway. Right? Hell of a show. Dead people and perverts and degenerates. Kind of fits right in here. Good morning, everybody. This is Uncle Scotty Barter, and welcome to the July 29th edition of the Kenosha Today Weekly Report. Coming to you live from Studio A here at AM 1050 WIP, streaming worldwide and booming across the sun-drenched cornfields of the Midwest, reaching out to over 50,000 homes here in the Tri-County area. Being brought to this morning by our major sponsors, the Boathouse Pub and Eatery and the legendary Brat Stop, along with a host of other very fine local businesses. Joining us this morning, making his return, our Kenosha Today Director of Cybersecurity, master of protecting us all from enemies of the world, Elmo Schneider.
Good morning, everyone.
So you were away last week and visiting with the Russians.
I was meeting with a group of Russian scientists.
These two girls' names were
Nadia and Tatiana.
You didn't touch Tatiana, did you?
Well, no, we're working on a very...
Yeah, I'm sure, secret.
We're collaborating on a big project. We're colluding on a big project.
This is going to set American-Russian relations back 50 years.
We found out they actually have Boris Yeltsin's body on ice over there, and they're looking at a way to revive it. And they think they've figured out they're going to replace all his bodily fluids with vodka. And they would like to use you as a prototype, since that's...
So that's what Foxconn wanted me for. We're going to get into that. I could be a prototype for vodka. And you, what are you going to be a prototype for? That brown rot gut you drink?
No, let's not go there.
Oh, yeah, it's okay to take me down. And missing again this morning, our spiritual advisor, who's up in the North Woods, trying to bond with some bears, I guess. What do you bond with? We were talking about that in the North Woods. What do you bond with?
10 to 1, he's hanging out at the Thirsty Whale. That's a good bar up there.
Okay.
So that's it.
Well, our good father from our... I don't think he hangs out in bars. Do you think? we'll find out.
Is that part of the Lumberjack song?
Yeah. Can't you see him with those clerical collars, you know?
He was up in northern Wisconsin. Yeah.
And the Lumberjack, the red plaid hat, you know, and the suspenders. As always, with us this morning, our video coordinator, the master of being politically incorrect, Spider Ronnie, the camera dude, joins us here at Camp Happy Face. Spider, what's new in your world?
Nothing.
You know, the you were filling in and sitting here, and somebody thought that you looked like you were propped up at a Weekend at Bernie's.
Yep, exactly.
You didn't have, show a lot of enthusiasm. No, well, you're back in your element back by the curtains over there.
Yeah.
See that waffling,
Carol Merrill,
and joining us once again, engineering the Kenosha Today trolley ride back from his 3-hour cruise from last week. Wacky Wayne is here, and he's in the house.
Wayne.
Now we got all my hate mail sorted out, and you're going to be missing. You're going on vacation to the North Woods next week, right?
Yes.
And where are you going?
Tomahawk, Wisconsin.
You taking the missus?
Oh, taking the whole family.
Yeah, her family lives up there, so we're going to go visit them.
Oh, the in-laws. There's the in-laws. Oh, boy. You're only going to be gone for 1 week?
Only 3-4 days. Yeah, something like that.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, it'll be fine. Love hanging out up there. There's nothing to do but drink and relax. I could use some drinking and relaxing.
This is
come
very
to a production.
Yeah, that's right.
No, because then I got to worry about driving back, and it's just
We can find a place for
you. I could probably Uber with Captain Mike. It'd be great.
Oh boy, there.
Uber from Tomahawk to Kenosha. How much is that going to cost?
A couple of bucks.
Get on the train that Captain Mike takes, and you'll still be in Tomahawk next month.
Right? Yeah.
Once again, this week, the Kenosha Today Secret Word Challenge, sponsored by Mike Bjorn's Clothing, located in...
Oh, you want that.
Hot.
Oh.
There you go.
There we go.
Downtown Kenosha, offering the biggest selection of men's suits in all of southeastern Wisconsin, northern Illinois, starting at only $179, which includes the shirt, tie, belt, and a pair of socks, with sizes starting at 34 short, going all the way up to size 60. You can find them on Facebook or call them at 262-652-0648. We've had a report because we're getting close to Labor Day weekend when the big car show is going to be down there. I think it's on Saturday, whatever that Saturday, September 3rd or 4th, and whether 6th Avenue is going to be completed. And they're about 10 days behind, but the mayor, God love him, says
it'll be done.
It'll be done, so thy will be done. And if it ain't, the Lord wept. Last week's secret word was, what was last week's secret word?
Don't look at me.
No, it wasn't swamp, was it?
No. That was a couple weeks before.
That was a couple weeks. I forgot to change this. What, Spider, what was, you were hanging on my every word last week. What was it? Nobody got it.
I wasn't here.
Nobody got it, and I forget what it was. I just barely had it spelled.
It was something about OJ. I can't remember what it was.
Yeah, was it,
Rehabilitated.
Rehabilitated. Yeah, no wonder nobody got it.
Right?
It's too many syllables.
Yeah. The Kenosha Today Brain Trust, is that going to be too many syllables?
Probably.
We'll see.
Syllables.
First hint.
Syllables, yeah. The Kenosha Today Brain Trust has pre-selected this morning's secret word, and the first caller to say the secret word win $25 gift certificate, compliments of Mike Bjorn's Clothing. Coming up after the 10:30 break, Kenosha's fastest growing game show sensation, of course, the lightning round of City and Jeopardy, sponsored by the Boathouse Pub and Eatery. And then after the 11 o'clock break, this week's top 10 thought-provoking category. And actually, I didn't change this one either. I was a little pressed for time. I spent too much time on the golf course. These are the top 10 reasons Foxconn should come to Kenosha.
Should build
their plant in Kenosha. That's what the top 10 is this week. And then the drama continues in the second hour around 11:20 when we drain the swamp, let our listeners try to stump the chumps, and prove to the rest of the Kenosha Today Nation that Point Away to something more than just your blood alcohol level. You still get two free fish dinners at the American Legion Post, 21504 58th Street. But you're going to have, because they're going to be going undergoing some remodeling, so if you are successful at stumping the chumps, that will be post-dated until after September 1st. Or you can waive all that and come in and join us for 1 hour in an upcoming show. Or... Hey, what's it, 3 weeks? August 19th, we are going to be on location over at Pete's Place in the morning celebrating Elmo's birthday party.
Oh, boy.
So
birthday extravaganza.
Birthday extravaganza. What could go wrong there, right?
Thank God they got a dump button in here.
It's and you're going to be back here, apparently.
Probably, yeah.
It's also Jim Selovich's birthday and another notable birthday on that day, Bill Clinton.
That's right.
Bubba. You gonna have Bubba come in? We're gonna have some. You gonna do some Bubba songs?
Oh, we got women in blue dresses. cigars.
And smoking cigars, and there's even more, boys and girls. Hey, why don't you get
dry cleaner on hand?
Well, not that. Why don't you get some of those Oktoberfest girls?
I could work on that.
You know, I mean, it's your birthday.
You said you just ran into one of them the other day.
Yeah. Our special editorial segment, sponsored by the legendary Brat Stop as the Brat Turn. Attaboy Spider, you come look at that. He's coming to life over there. This week's high fives, zingers, and doofuses. If that's your excitement, yeah. As only heard here on the Kenosha Today Show, and it gets even better, folks, for those who might have forgotten, tomorrow at noon each and every Sunday, you can tune in here at AM 1050 WIP and listen to the replay. And then, it gets even better. You can watch Or maybe it doesn't. You can watch the replay of this finely tuned, professionally produced Excuse for Radio show on Time Warner Cable's Channel 14, Tuesdays at 5, Wednesdays at 6, and...
The media's making a monster out of you because they don't care about the truth. All they care about is entertainment. Well, you need a forum where they don't even know the meaning of the word entertainment. Public access television.
Sundays at 6, and also everybody can now sign up with the thousands of our fans and listeners who have joined the Kenosha Nation. Like us on Facebook. And you can also join in the KenoshaToday.com on the web. And if anybody wants to join us every Friday afternoon at 3 o'clock, getting silly, the production meeting. Elmo and I were down on the deck, and they had this, the AMC car. I think they were all over at Jeffrey's school. And then they were going to have this big doing at the History Center. What was the film they were going to run? The
why the AMC Pacer was such a dismal failure.
So there had to be hundreds of cars, probably starting at 3:30, coming over the bridge, and it was the most, I don't even...
Nobody knew where to go.
Nobody knew where to go, and they're going over the bridge, and you talk about a
cluster
debacle. Yeah. I've never seen, people, and they're only one little cop on a motorcycle, and I don't think he knew where everybody was going, so... I think the planning of that deal left a little bit
lacking
to be desired. So anyway, a number of things. Geez, what went on in this town and nationally this week? I guess where do we start? Should we talk about...
Elmo got in at 2:30 in the morning.
Yeah, Elmo got in at 2:30. What do we know to talk about? Our buddy Ryan Priebus is out, and... I thought he did a great job. You know, didn't he kind of mastermind the strategy to get Trump in there?
Yeah.
And
RNC had.
And so now if anybody wants to comment on that, I don't think he's going to have to wait too long to find other employment because he's a very sharp individual.
You're looking for a chief of staff, aren't you?
Oh, yeah, but does he drink? He will when he gets to our doorstep. Well, we don't think we could pay him, but you know what? He could... he could almost name his ticket with Foxconn coming to Wisconsin and almost in his backyard because still has his house in Summers. I mean, he could help run that deal, or he could probably, in the meantime, end up on CNN or one of those talk shows. Mm-hmm. He'd be a very marketable person, more than what MSNBC and CNN, and of course you like Fox because of all the girlies.
The ladies.
News bunnies. So if anybody wants to comment whether they think Reince got a raw deal, I mean, six months.
You know, after the election, he did say that his plan was to just take some time off and relax after being head of the RNC and working on the campaign for that long.
Well, that's true.
You know, move back to Kenosha and just, you know.
Yeah, he doesn't
cool it for a while. Yeah. He deserves a vacation.
Sure. And, of course, this Anthony Scaramucci, who just... I don't know where this guy's coming from. First of all, I never heard of him. He's the new chief of staff. Or no, not he's not chief of staff. He's the communications director.
Right.
And to use that kind of language, I mean, every kid in elementary school is going to use this kind of language and say, well, Trump's guy's using it. Why can't I? Good morning on Kenosha Today.
Hi, yeah, this is Jeff from Racine.
Yeah, Jeff.
Hey, what was that deal on, it says, I saw a little tape thing on the television that ran by and said something about Wisconsin will be paying Foxconn $200 million for 12 years if they come here?
I believe it's $3 billion over 15 years.
No, $200 million for 12 years, like $200 million a year.
Well, I don't know. Was that meaning those were incentives to come here, or I missed that.
I don't know what it meant either. I just saw the tape on, you know, how it runs under the picture, you know, the news.
Well, let me see. Okay.
Don't believe anything you see on television is my advice. So.
Well, no, but I mean, it does, you know, that's something we haven't, you know, I don't think I want to go suck lemons or anything either.
Well, you know, I have all of those articles, and I don't recall reading that other than I know that sometime in the next, by the end of September, the Wisconsin legislature, right?
Almost, yeah, they still have to approve that.
They have to approve one of this. whatever they're going to decide and where they're going to put this thing. And
right.
I know one of the incentives was they had to finish the fourth lane on I-94. That was a given, you know, because they quit where Kenosha was 142 all the way up to maybe northern Racine County. So I know they got to do that. And
what I heard was $3 billion over 15 years, but it's benchmarked that based on the number of jobs they have at,
at the plant. Okay.
If they don't have the jobs there, they don't get the cash.
Right. Does that sound about right to you?
They didn't explain it that way. They just, you know, to sensationalize it, just said Wisconsin will be paying Foxconn $200 million over 12 years.
Yeah,
but Elmo, 12 years, and the $200 million come from the taxpayers.
Well, but Elmo is right. There was a benchmark, and that was you had to have a certain amount of jobs. I heard that.
And they're before they get
before
the money.
They, you know.
Right.
So
right.
We're just
well,
not
let's hope
here.
So. Let's hope everything. You know.
Now, do you? You said you're from Racine.
Yeah.
Well, whether it's from Racine, here's the other side of this. Whether it be Racine or Kenosha, it's going to create a tremendous influx of people coming here in the housing market, right? I mean, they got to move all of these 10,000.
They got to live someplace.
They got to live someplace.
Well, yeah, but if it doesn't work out, or if it, you know, there's so many things going on in the financial area.
Well, I've heard that
within the last 10 years or 15 years, maybe that you know, you got to be really careful. You know, if it's too good to be true. Maybe this takes more to let's look into it, make sure
you're right.
And dot the I's and cross the
exactly.
T's, you know.
And anytime you have politicians involved, therein lies a problem. But let's say you're a real estate developer and now all of a sudden this has all been finalized and you know, this memorandum of understanding and we have a contract with Foxconn and let's say they are gonna put it in Sturtevant, we'll just say. Do you imagine how many more schools and police fire?
Sure.
I mean, it's not a...
Oh, you bet.
Mm-hmm. We're going to...
And then if it falls through, everybody goes bankrupt, and, you know, what do? Become a third world country?
Aren't we now?
No, well, I don't know.
Yeah.
You know,
I was just wondering. I saw that, and I thought, wow, that's quite a...
Go ahead, Emma.
You know, you talk about falling through. You know, they're talking about 13,000 jobs here. You know, currently Foxconn has 1 million employees worldwide. So this is not a big deal for them. You know,
well,
it is for us, but it's really not for them.
Oh, sure.
But it's going to come at a cost. And let's say the people in Little Summers, in all those cornfields, and they can barely rent them out for soybeans. And now I heard a developer could come in. And they're talking $50,000 an acre.
That's cheap.
And it could be cheap. But it's right now they're probably paying agricultural prices about $7,000 an acre.
No,
it's
still.
Oh, yeah, and my land up north will go sky high because nobody wants to live in the big metropolis, you know.
Yeah. Well, it's going to bring a total change to this community, southeastern Wisconsin, in my view. And you're right. We'll have to follow all of this.
Yeah, I just was wondering about that, though. Okay,
you know,
well, thanks a lot.
All right, thank you.
Once they run the trolley out there, forget water. Boy.
Yeah, forget water. When we have
wheels on it, put wheels on it in case there's a, you know, in case the road gets, you have to redirect.
Yeah, we're not charging.
The tracks won't go there. You know?
I don't know
if
about.
You got wheels, you can go.
I don't know about Racine, but we have our share of potholes, and we're not charging extra for any of those, though.
Oh, yeah, we have potholes, too.
All right.
Yeah.
All right.
Amazing. Okay.
All right, thanks.
All righty, bye-bye.
262-694-1050. If you have some comments, I guess we have quite a few comments.
Boy,
coming
board's up. Lighting up here.
Good morning on Kenosha Today.
Good morning, everyone.
Morning, Shirley.
Good morning, Shirley.
Good morning. I'm kind of disappointed.
Oh, yeah?
You weren't the first
caller. You ran out of vodka or what?
I heard through the grapevine that Steve was going to be there today. Steve Casey, did you hear anything about that? Or?
Well, obviously I didn't because he's not here.
He's not here. Huh?
Yeah. I heard it, but I guess it wasn't fake news, I guess.
Well, he had asked me, but that wasn't for this time, but the discussion didn't go any further, so I don't know what happened in that case, so we'll see what happens. So,
mm-hmm.
Hey, what do you think our, in fact, I got a Real quick, go ahead. Did you have something to?
No, I just you know heard that he was going to be back, but
Well, we'll see.
We'll see.
My phones are lit up, Shirley.
Okay, I just wanted to say good morning.
Okay, well, there we go. Okay, no.
Yeah.
Okay.
I got a new one.
Could I say something about the Harbor Market and those dogs?
Yeah,
that
real quick.
Dogs should not be down there.
Yeah, we're going to talk about that.
Yep.
I agree to that. Yeah. All right, Shirley. Thanks.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Good morning. You're on Kenosha today.
Good morning. This is Cindy. How are you guys?
Hi, Cindy.
Hi. I got a question for Elmo.
Okay.
All right.
Okay, Steve, I heard that not too long ago, well, this all came up on my patio the other day. I heard that you were somewhere and witnessed my nephew doing his rendition of Walk Like a Man.
I don't remember the song, but he was the Chuckster was there. We had our picture taken together.
Yeah, that's what, and he just was curious. Where did you send that picture?
Well, to the Russians.
No, to my
the Russians.
I sent it to my sister.
Oh.
You know, we're all in the neighborhood. They're the same age. You know,
so right. Yep. Yeah, I was just curious. Yeah, he said you guys. Did he do a good job?
Sure. Yeah, he's a very good singer, actually. So.
Yeah. Well, he used to be with a band, and they did a lot of covers of AC/DC, and boy, he just sounded just so much like, you know, their lead singer.
Yeah, dude, he was pretty good. I never knew he could sing.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I just was curious about that, and my surgery's coming up on the 9th. I don't know, Steve, if you heard this, but they're going to add another vertebrae to my fusion.
How do they do that?
They're going to go in through the side of my back, and then they're going to turn me over and go through the back of my back and replace a couple of screws. I guess I had a screw loose. Yeah. Who knew?
You'll be out golfing by the end of the week.
Yeah.
All right, Cindy, thanks.
Swing and a miss.
Yeah. Yep. There you go.
All right, guys.
All right. Good morning. You're on Kenosha today.
Yeah. All right. Swing and a miss.
Who's this?
There you go. All right, guys.
Who is this?
Hi, how's it going, Scott? This is Dennis.
Oh, yeah.
Dennis is too busy listening to the radio to be on it.
Is your wife giving you orders for today? You're hanging on her every word instead of talking to me?
No, actually, I just got through with the Waterford, or Knights of Columbus, on a Dr. Road cleanup.
You're on the cleanup committee?
We just picked up a lot of garbage along Route 83 that runs through Waterford.
Well, that's a good job for you.
You find anything interesting?
Actually, I did. I found something I can give to one of the schools that I'm affiliated with for their art class.
What?
A tire?
Yeah.
It was a little kind of a wooden poster board with a catchy saying for art students on it.
Boy, that's every art kid's dream to have that come from you, from your collection.
From the gutter.
From the gutter of Dennis.
It would be somebody's goal in life, I'll tell you. I wanted to comment. I called in on a remote at the end of the show last week, reporting on the beginning of Tribute Island.
Yeah.
I want to tell you something. That was, as far as I was concerned, I was there both days, and it was, to me, a huge success.
Really? You're the only one that I've talked to that said that, but... I mean, I'm
really?
I've heard the other side. It was too spread out, and it was. This is what I heard. So I'm not judging it one way or another. If you had a good time.
Oh, okay. I don't know what. I spent most of my time at the dock stage with bands that probably we would recognize. I didn't go by the heavy metal or some of the other stages they had. So I don't know what was. I saw Captain Mike. He was there.
Yeah, he left me at the boathouse, and he had his little bicycle.
He was on his tricycle?
And his tricycle, his little pink flag.
He was on his bike.
Yeah.
He's a Kenosha icon. Everybody, when he'd show up, people in the crowd were yelling for him.
Was he
yelling?
Yeah, what was he yelling to?
Get the hell out.
And by the way, I don't want to be misquoted. I said icon, not eyesore, okay?
Oh, okay. All right. Well, thanks for clarifying that.
And I wanted to... let you know that, with your permission, Nancy and I would like to take you up. We have delayed our collection of that one prize. We'd like to, I think we spoke with you and Elmo about coming in at Elmo's birthday party
from
11 to 12 that week at Pete's Place.
Yeah. Sure. Do you have a certain song, a dedication song for his birthday that you and the missus can sing?
I'll work one up. I've done that for friends in the past. I will work up a song parody, especially for Elmo.
Okay. Do you need background music? Because if you do, we have it.
No, yeah.
We have it. Right. Yeah. Whatever it is, we can get
it off of YouTube or whatever. But how old is Elmo going to be?
Oh, I don't know if Elmo wants to say.
28.
Yeah. How old?
28. He's got underwear older than that.
And 783,000 days.
That's in dog years.
I'll be coming to a production meeting so I can find out a few more facts that I can more adeptly craft a song, especially made for him.
Hey, you want to talk about a song? You know, our buddy Ryan Priebus submitted his resignation. He's no, you know, to the Trumpster. Here's what we're telling and encouraging Reince to tell Trump.
Been shoving. I ain't working here no more. A woman done left and took all the reason I was working for. You better not try to stand in my way as I'm walking out the door. Take this job and shove it. I ain't working here no more.
Our boy Reince Priebus, yep, to the President of the United States.
Actually, I think there was Nancy in my wedding theme song. That was their song for my wedding, I think.
You're still crying about that? That ship has sailed.
It's a beautiful song to dance to. It's great.
Okay, Dennis. Well, I'll see you, man. You go back in the ditch and look for more artifacts for all those snot little kids in Waterford.
I will see you next at your next production meeting. And by the way, I just want to give a plug. Nancy and I are planning on going. Her aunt passed away several years back from breast cancer. Huh. We're going to the Relay for Life at Parkside next Friday.
Okay.
Very good.
All right. We'll see you then.
All right. Take it easy.
Oh, these phones lit up this first half hour. We didn't even get a chance to take a break. We're going to have to take
We're going to have to do that.
Who's this new guy now?
Worcester?
The Worcester?
Todd Worcester? Yeah, he's been here a couple of weeks now.
Really?
Yeah. Have you not been paying attention, Scotty?
We had the Shenansky guy.
Yeah. And Nisnansky.
Snisnansky. And then we had this Worcester guy is somebody new.
Yeah, he's replacing the
Brock
beer man.
Worcester?
The beer man.
Yeah, we had the beer man, yeah.
Why don't we get one of these guys to come down here and do this weather live for us?
Because they know better.
Big time, powerful AM radio station.
We'll
be back in a couple minutes. Tuned in, this is Uncle Scotty Barter, and welcome to the July 29th edition of the Kenosha State Weekly Report, coming to you live from Studio A here at AM 1050 WLFP, spreading the love here at Camp Happy Face. Also bringing you gas trolleys, stray cats, backyard beavers, and two free seats if you're still interested in Uncle Scotty's Ark and saving the Kenosha State Nation. And again, we invite you to join the thousands of fans who have already signed up and liked us on Facebook. And you can visit us on the web at KenoshaToday.com, designed by Kappa Web Design. And also brought to you today by our major sponsors, the Boathouse Pub and Eatery and the legendary Brat Stop, along with a host of many other very fine local businesses. In the first half hour, no one has won this morning's Secret Word Challenge, sponsored by Mike Bjorn's Clothing. And if any of our callers mention the secret word, you win a $25 gift certificate, compliments of Mike Bjorn's Clothing, located in downtown Kenosha, offering the largest selection of men's suits, starting at $179, with sizes ranging from 34 all the way up to 60. And if you just joined us, our special guest again this morning, Director of Cybersecurity, back from a meeting with two Russian gals. How do we know that this was on the up and up and there was no... how do you say hanky-panky in Russian? Or we don't.
It's probably better that we don't.
Also joining us here at Camp Happy Face, the Kenosha State Love Doctor, Spider Ronnie's here.
Hey.
And obviously engineering the Kenosha State Trolley Ride, Wacky Wayne's here. And this show is being recorded for training purposes and maybe for some upcoming litigation. And also our special thanks to my good friend Elmo here. You can find the Kenosha Today show 365 days a year, 24/7 up on YouTube. We're current with all this, aren't we?
We just put up the
okay.
The legendary farm animal show just went up. So
Well, that was... you missed that one.
Oh, I'm almost sorry I did. Almost.
Coming up after 11 o'clock, today's top 10 category, the top 10 reasons Foxconn should build their plant here in Kenosha. And then the drama continues at 11:20 when we drain the swamp, stump the chumps, followed by As the Brat Turns after the 11:30 break.
Oh.
And now, boys and girls, it's time to play Kenosha's fastest-growing game show sensation, the Lightning Round of City in Jeopardy, sponsored by the Boathouse Pub and Eatery. And to be eligible, you ever played a violin or the harp?
Just a piano.
Just a piano. Be eligible, no one from your household could have won any contest on WIP within the last 60 days. The phone lines are clear, and I'm going to read the question, which you will see is a very sophisticated, intelligent, multiple-choice question. And then you will get three somewhat intellectual answers to choose from. And after that, you'll hear the ding. Yummo. And you kind of slow there.
It's that week off.
Correctly answer the question. Wins a Kenosha Today $25 gift certificate to the Boathouse Pub and Eatery, located at 4917 7th Avenue here in Kenosha. Open Mondays through Fridays at 11 a.m., featuring weekly lunch and dinner specials. Enjoy a beautiful waterfront view and stop in for their big Saturday and Sunday morning breakfast and Bloody Mary specials beginning at 7 a.m. until noon. And if you're planning a party or a banquet, call Joyce, 262-654-9922, or you can find them on the web at theboathousekenosha.com. The phone lines are clear. Here's the sophisticated question. What is the most important thing to do when applying for a high-tech job? What's the most important thing to do when applying for a high-tech job? A, listing 0.08 as the highest grade you've completed. B, that you are very prolific in the use of an Etch-a-Sketch. Or C, using the Boathouse parking lot as your mailing address, 262-694-1050. What is the most important thing to do when applying for a high-tech job? Listing 0.08 as the highest grade that you've completed. B, that you are very prolific in the use of an Etch-a-Sketch. Or C, using the Boathouse parking lot as your mailing address, 262-694-1050. What happened to all the calls there, Wayne? Did you clear everybody out?
That was clearing the lines.
Yeah, I cleared the lines. Sick.
All right, well, if somebody wants to take a shot at the City in Jeopardy, give us a call. In the meantime...
Oh, here we go.
Oh, okay, here we go. A little slow there.
All right.
Yes?
We'll give it a whirl.
Good morning, you're on Kenosha Today.
Oh, here we go. Okay.
Hello.
Yes, who's this?
Bernie Frisine.
Bernie. Okay, Bernie, a couple questions here. Do you go by Bernie, Bernard, or...
Bubba.
Bubba.
Bubba. That's the brother.
Okay, Bern. Or Bern. All right, here's the question. What is the most important thing to do when applying for a high-tech job? A, listing 0.08 as the highest grade you've completed. B, that you are very prolific in the use of an Etch-a-Sketch. Or C, using the Boathouse parking lot as your mailing address. Bernie.
Is number C.
Using the Boathouse parking lot as your mailing address. Yes, that's the most important thing. We have a winner. So, the other one, how far in school did you go?
I got a master's degree and two sub-master's degrees.
And you're calling this show? What's the matter with you, Bernie? I'm
trying to get well-educated.
Wow. Boy, you're bringing something that we're not really attuned to, education here in this... in this show, but we're delighted that you did. You are you retired?
Yes, I am 72.
Oh, you retired in 72, or you're 72?
I am retired. I am 72.
Oh, okay. So you're wise. You have maturity and sophistication. Well, 72 is not old. It's a number.
That's it.
Hey, since you seem to know everything here, Bernie. Well, two master's degrees and two sub-master's degrees. I mean, we don't get a lot of those callers. You know, our callers, you know, they're going, I'd have to go back. That's what I had to put, listing 0.08 as the highest grade point you've completed, because that's our average. That's our average listener. But did you hear this about in River Falls, Wisconsin, companies offering a microchip to put in its employees? That allows them to open doors and log on their computers. I think it's about the size of a little pea, right?
Yeah.
Grain of rice.
A grain of rice, yeah.
Yeah.
What do you think of that deal?
Not for me.
Well, you're retired. What?
Not for me. My wife would know where I am then.
Okay. Well, that's the whole problem. This is my next question. This was started just for people to open doors and log on to their computers and purchase break room snacks. But so if this gets through here in River Falls, what's the next step? Who would you get a microchip for, and why? Is my question, Bernie. You don't get
probably Scaramucci, because I'd like to find out where he's going next.
Yeah. Now, what do you think of that kind of language?
Not appropriate.
Oh, my God. Now you could take every kid in elementary school that's going to be using that and say, well, Trump's guy can talk like this. Why can't I?
Exactly. Mm.
So you don't think, going back to my microchip question, you don't think that your wife would have you chipped up, would you? Would she?
She probably would. Oh, that's why I say I don't like the idea.
Well, this is a community property state, so if you get one, she's got to get one, right?
But she's got more than me anyways. It doesn't matter.
Now, that's just one man's opinion. All right, Bernie, here's what's going to happen. Off the air, Wacky Wayne's going to get your full name and address and a phone number, and I'm going to mail you this certificate on Monday, and you'll get $25. It's a Kenosha Today certificate. You take in the boathouse. And
very good.
Tell them you won with that question, too. You want the address?
I will do that.
You wouldn't use the, well, I guess you thought using the boathouse parking lot as a mailing address would, you won
with
that.
That's why I want to go there.
There you go. All right, Ernie.
All right.
All right, thanks for calling in. Don't go away, though.
All right.
Wacky Wayne's doing that. I got to read a sponsor here.
And best beer selection.
Hang on.
And best chicken, but they don't have that, so.
Yeah, the Kenosha.
There's no category for that. So
they have all these categories: best of auto, best of education, and unfortunately, I think they've done this a couple of years. We're not going to win.
Do they have best local radio show?
No. The reason we're not going to win is they don't have a category called shows that suck big time. So I don't. I don't think we're going to get anything on this thing. But that's about it. So you have to, we have to go on there on the Kenosha News website?
Go online, KenoshaNews.com/bestofKenosha. You have until through tomorrow to put the nomination in.
So all right. And, of course, KRS Painting Corporation, specializing in commercial. It's Priebus, or if you want to talk about the aide that blasted him, the Scaramucci guy. Mm-hmm. And you want to talk about Foxconn, good or bad? I think it's probably all good, but, you know, at what cost has it come to us? We are going to have to buy, whether it ends up in Kenosha or Racine, my view, we're going to have to pay or build at least 3 more elementary schools, another middle school, and possibly another high school. And all comes, you know, what's an elementary school go for about these years, days? About $30 million. Just for, Tremper was built in 64 for $24 million. Of course, it leaked like a sieve, but and we're going to have some more police and fire and.
You never know. Foxconn may have their own school there. They're going to be that big. So
well, they're talking about Wisconsin Valley and could cover nearly almost two square miles, three times the size of the Pentagon. You know, how come they compared it to the Pentagon and not something like we can recognize here in Kenosha, such as the Velodrome? How many velodromes
can you fit inside? You can fit 11 Lambeau fields in there. Yeah. How many velodromes can you fit in there?
And if you think having these microchips is a good idea, who would you want to have put a microchip on and why? We have that question. And also, if you have a question about the dogs in either Harbor Market or we were talking about this earlier, I don't think they allowed dogs to church festivals. I don't recall seeing one because that's on private property.
Yeah, I have no idea.
And so
it's not nice to the dogs to put them in a crowd. That's all.
I mean, there's so many things that could happen, and they're all bad. Mm-hmm. Whether a dog bites somebody or starts lapping on some hot dogs sitting there, and I don't think
pizza.
Yeah. Hey, that's my dog imitation.
We're trying to eat a pizza here. All right. Get rid of that dog.
So if you have a question on whether dogs should be allowed, and of course, not a good week for Trump because the Obamacare thing went down the tubes.
It's not his fault.
Huh? Well, I know. We have a caller that's of any importance?
Sure, we'll give it a whirl.
That's some confidence, huh?
Sure, we'll give it a whirl.
Good morning on Kenosha Today.
Yeah, Scott. It's Captain Mike Scott.
I see now why Wayne's hesitating. Yeah,
the world.
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, well, speaking about dogs, I want to retract my statement from last year. Remember you asked me about what was your worst date? It was that blind date when I said I was hitting the brake and the gas pedal, and it wasn't to hurt the girl at all. It was my friend in the back seat that fixed me up. He was with the queen of the hop, and every time he went to kiss her, I'd hit the brake. It was 1967 or 68. I remembered. I was sitting here thinking. I says, that's what I was doing. So he'd miss kissing her. You know, he'd maybe hit his head on the window.
Boy, they did all kinds of funny things back in those days, didn't they?
You do that when you're driving Uber, Captain?
Yeah.
I can't say. I'm taking the fifth on that one.
You probably had a fifth already.
Shh. I'm up to 4.5. I'll see you in a little bit.
Hey,
yeah.
What do you think about having a microchip in somebody? If you had your choice, one person, to put a microchip where you could find out where he or she is, who would that be and why?
Do they still have the Playmate of the Year?
aren't you a little out of your skill level? Playmate of the Year? Yeah, maybe you can go to the senior division.
Yeah.
She'll be nice and her skin will be nice and pruny looking by now.
Get a dog whistle and that girl will come back from 50 years ago or something.
I can tell you how sincere you are with calling in to apologize. Oh, man.
No, I did. It's not true. I wouldn't really hurt anybody. When I started thinking about it, that's what it was. Every time my friend went to kiss his girlfriend, I'd hit the brake or the gas, depending. You know?
And it was great fun watching her forehead slam
He was kind of lipping. I'm sorry, because he'd never seen her. His girlfriend fixed me up with her. There was no part that was nice of her. I picked her up at a funeral home, and it went downhill. She told me how to drive, this or that. I don't this.
Like my question to you last week, was she the corpse?
Her voice was like a blackboard screeching. It was just a horrible thing.
Oh, I can tell you're calling in to apologize to this gal.
I hurt her.
I know. You feel very sorry 50-some years later.
I'm sure sorry I met her or anything like that, but I didn't want to hurt her. You know?
Hey, the question you went down to... The car thing. No, the car thing yesterday, right? Over the bridge.
I went to the bridge with my contraption and watched all the cars go into the yacht club. I never went to the yacht club, though.
Oh, you never went over the bridge, right?
No. Okay. No, but you could see everything that went over the bridge by being right there on the bridge. Plus, you got to see the cars running and revving up their engines and stuff. So.
What did you think of the festival, the Simmons Island thing last week?
I liked it. Yeah. I had a lot of fun.
I heard you were out there kind of misbehaving and dancing and putting the make on some of these young gals.
Well, I was trying to be myself.
What are you laughing for?
I don't know, because you're laughing. Everybody's laughing. I don't know. Not sure I'm laughing.
What do you think about Foxconn? You know, this is going to be a boom for the Uber drivers.
Well, yeah, that's right. That would be, yeah. I don't know. My friend's coming from Mexico, and he needs a job, so I think it might be good for him. He's been down there 10 years, and he's running across some bad luck down there, so it'd be good for him, I think. You know?
Yeah, otherwise he's going to have to sit in your alley and drink Muscatel like you do when you go to when you go to Mexico.
The truth. Yeah. The truth serum, Muscatel. Okay.
All right, well. Thanks for bringing absolutely nothing to the table this morning.
Thanks, Scotty. You're welcome.
I won't make the production meeting today. Oh, you know what? You know what? Pat Garrett, as long as I got here, is paying at 3:00 on the jazz stage for an hour. So I'm going down to see him. Taste of Wisconsin.
Well, I'll probably see you down. I'm planning on going.
Yeah, you bring in your little.
Yep.
Where do you park that thing?
Well, I just sit on it. I just sit on it, and it's very comfortable.
What, his girlfriend?
Well, I park it about once an hour by the porta potties.
Oh, yeah. Hey, by the way, Wacky Wayne's just traumatized knowing that you're not going to be his roommate when he goes to grad school.
Losing sleep.
He's losing sleep over this.
Cold sweats.
Cold sweat.
Tossing, turning.
Yeah, well, poor guy, man.
Yeah, somehow I have to get by without it. Yeah.
All right. I'll see you later.
Okay, you guys. Goodbye.
Yeah, we got a couple minutes left. If you have a call, 262-694-1050. We talked about microchips. We talked about the president. What I started was John McCain with the health thing. He has a brain, didn't he have brain surgery?
Tumor?
No, he had a blood clot removed.
Oh, okay.
But when they did that, they found a tumor in there.
So he gets out of his deathbed and goes from Arizona, right, to Washington to supposedly cast the winning vote. Well, he cast, if I got this right, he cast the vote that made him talk about it.
Mm-hmm.
And then he went the other way and cast the vote that says Kaputsky.
Death panels for all.
So now,
if you're really rich.
So now, then we'll have to probably go to a break. Your version of...
we have Elmo Care.
Elmo Care, which is?
Cash or death. Take your pick.
That seems pretty...
Problem solved.
Problem solved.
Easy peasy lemon squeezy.
Yeah. And if you're Reince Priebus, we got that up there one more time before we go to a break. Yeah. If you're Reince Priebus, here's what you got to tell the Trumpster this morning.
Take this job and shove it. I ain't working here no more. A woman done left and took all the reason I was working for. You better not try to stand in my way as I'm walking out the door. Take this job and shove it. I ain't working here no more. I've been working in this factory for now 15 years. All this time I watched my woman drowning in a pool of tears. And I've seen a lot of...
Uncle Scotty Barter, and welcome to the July 29th edition of the Kenosha Today Weekly Report, broadcasting live from Studio A here at AM 1050 WIP on your radio dial, being brought to you by our major sponsors, the Boathouse Pub and Eatery and the legendary Brat Stop, along with a host of many other very fine local businesses. Taking serious journalism, except for that part when Captain Mike calls in, to an all-time high, reporting on local stories, state stories, and spanning the globe, keeping it real, spreading the love, and just trying to be all-around good guys. Joining us again this morning, our director of cyber security, Elmo Schneider.
Good morning.
And who claims, as for those that follow this show, he was not with us last week because he was with two Russian, what would their titles be?
Scientists.
Oh, scientists. Oh, that's what they're going by. What are they, science of?
Love.
Nah, love science.
what is it? I can't think. What do they got? What do they do when they freeze a dead guy?
What's cryogenics?
Cryogenics. Okay, I can't think of that.
This guy with you, Carthage College is not very proud of you.
17 years of college for him. Yeah, took like right. A year of trade school.
I literally. A year of trade school.
I literally had a brain freeze there. Yeah.
No pun intended.
So, what did you say they were trying to bring back?
Boris Yeltsin.
Boris Yeltsin. Hey, didn't they? Wasn't Walt Disney frozen?
Yes.
Yep.
Is he still under?
Yeah, he's still on ice.
On ice. Yeah.
They
got Disney on ice.
They got Ted Williams' head going down there too. So that's.
I think when my demise comes, I'd like to be frozen and put in that cooler behind in the boathouse in the bar. Polish him up. with us as he is every Saturday, our video coordinator, Spider Ronnie, Happy Face, and engineering the Kenosha Day train wreck, who's got all the answers, obviously.
So it would seem.
Yeah, so Wacky Wayne's here. And okay, for those who haven't signed on to like us on the Kenosha Day Facebook page, you better get on with it. And I'm going to post some of the most amazing things. You post that one about the Nash thing on yesterday.
The photo on
52nd Street. It had to be taken about the early
50s. Still had the thing going over the street.
Yeah.
It said Nash on it, not American Motors. So.
Status of the Secret Word Challenge to win $25 gift certificate from Mike Bjorn's Clothing. Nobody has guessed that yet. Offering the largest selection of men's suits anywhere on the planet, starting at only $179, which includes a shirt, tie, belt, and a pair of socks. And for all you guys who want to impress your sweetheart, get over to Mike Bjorn's Clothing and... I didn't know if we're going to... Right.
I mean, if you want to do it, you can.
No, that's right. No, you don't sound like
Buster Poindexter, but that's okay.
Downtown Kenosha, call him at 262-652-0648. And now, boys and girls, written in our home office, on the deck, at the Boathouse Pub and Eatery, at Amen Corner, where gray hairs matter, this week's top 10 thought-provoking category, the top 10 reasons Foxconn should build their plant here in Kenosha. Number 10. for only another 26 million, the Heritage House can be used as their corporate headquarters. Number 9, unlimited amount of liquid crystals available from the Lincoln Park Lagoon. Number 8, our state lawmakers have a great track record for screwing things up. Number 7, the liquor and pills will eventually wear off. Number 6, very liberal laws that allow you to burn your cheesehead in the backyard. Number 5, where else can you get on a trolley and go to nowhere? Number 4, got plenty of potholes available to house all their feral cats. And number 3, our school board has been talking in Chinese for years. Number 2, Kenosha produces more useless city ordinances per capita than any place in the world. And the number one reason Foxconn should build their plant here in Kenosha, our former 8th District Alderman has left Wisconn Valley and moved to Summers. That's the number one reason right there.
You know...
Good. Let the act finish here.
You read a little fast today, yeah. Scott.
I got a little excited, you know?
I guess.
See, when you're on a roll...
I guess you just roll with it.
Downhill. I mean, I'm rolling fast. Go ahead.
You know, I got some advice for the Foxconn people. No matter where they decide to build this plant,
what?
Make sure to take out a permit.
Yeah. Yeah. $10 billion, right? $10 billion. Make sure you have a permit because, especially if it's in...
And don't build in a floodplain.
And don't build in a floodplain. Hypothetically speaking, yes. You know, you never know how that would work out, but who would ever consider putting a fence up? Just random, hypothetically. Yep. Who would ever consider building a fence on your yard, one without a permit? Everybody has to have a permit. I don't care if it's Summers, Pleasant Prairie, or Wisconn Valley. And you got to check your deed to make sure you're... If there's a water on your property, that's probably part of a floodplain. And so then you have to get...
They check that out when they're issuing a permit.
You might. Well, we've been talking about a number of topics today. If you want to call us, whether you want to... I think the health bill is pretty much Kaputsky for now. If you want to talk about...
Is that Russian?
Kaputsky, yeah.
Kaputsky.
That's the influence that Elmo has on me.
That was the name of the translator.
Kaputsky. And whether you want to comment on Reince Priebus, I don't think he's going to have problems. He's going to be probably a whole lot better off getting some TV deal or some analyst. But you heard on the news here at the top of the hour how classy he's handling this. He says, oh, yeah, it's for the best, and I'm still a Trump backer. And he handles it with style and grace, which he's always been. So
unlike the new guy there.
Yeah, who can use a kind of gutter language. And a couple other stories that we're following. This was a bidding for an FBI surveillance van.
The new Kenosha Today Mobile.
Yeah, it was listed on eBay. It was 1980s era FBI surveillance van, and it was a Dodge Ram 350, and was used in FBI investigations, and it was for sale on a government auction website. And in the back of the van are many custom features that had a toilet, extra 12-volt batteries, TV monitors, video recording equipment, and they also said there are also microphones hidden in the exterior of the van. And here's what kind of perked me up. It also, inside were handcuffs, binoculars, and even leftover video from an FBI stakeout. And
outside of Barter Manor?
Yeah, it's kind of Barter Manor on wheels with the handcuffs and all the binoculars. But so here... The auction on eBay ended with 47 bids, and the van sold for $18,700, according to the listing. I'm surprised that a 1989 van, but apparently all that stuff works. What are you going to do with this, something like that? Go spy on your neighbor?
Go spy in Summers.
Go spy in Summers. Stalking?
Yeah, you know.
Be a creepy stalker
in
Summers.
You'd be a creepy stalker in Summers.
And see, now the FBI doesn't have to do that stuff. They just put a chip. And I guess they can GPS and you know, that's kind of a scary tactic one, because any husband and wife, you know, when you go get married, you know, instead of exchanging rings, you exchange chips. And man, till death do us part, you'll have a whole new meaning.
You know, you forget that women's intuition thing. They don't matter. They don't need a chip. They know where you're at all the time anyway. So.
You paying attention to this?
Oh, one? Yeah. Hanging on his every word.
And here's another case, a woman accused of drunken, topless road rage.
Where was this?
In Massachusetts.
God damn it.
Uh-oh.
What?
Did you swear?
No. Oh, well, okay. I guess that's all a matter of your definition.
Oh, okay.
We're okay.
All right.
Okay.
Son of a...
Anyway, in Massachusetts,
boy, oh boy.
This gal is facing several felony charges after allegedly waving a dagger at another driver while topless in an apparent drunken road rage attack. This gal is only 39. You know what the name of this town in Massachusetts? Sandwich.
Yep.
All right. Sandwich, Massachusetts. Yep. She's driving a Ford Explorer. And police received a call from another driver who claimed the woman tried to crash into the victim's car. And then this gal pulls behind the victim's vehicle at a red light and began waving a double-edged dagger. And the Sandwich Police Department announced this on Monday. I'm not making this up. So she then allegedly got out of the Explorer and ripped off her shirt before running bare-chested toward the victim's car while... flashing the knife, and a caller who contacted the police meanwhile drove off, and apparently the police say she was intoxicated and later found her in a place and put her under arrest. Why can't we find gals like this running in down the streets of Kenosha?
I'm not so sure.
We haven't. 262-694-1050. Hey, we can play Stump the Chumps a little earlier. We had a lot of callers earlier, but all of a sudden, all the information kind of dried up.
Well, you know,
they're hanging on every word.
It's sunny outside.
You know, maybe, outside.
Maybe I better read a sponsor here.
Yeah.
A big thank you.
Yeah. Is this Scotty?
Who's this?
Oh, is this?
Yeah. Who's this?
Yeah. This is Jeff.
Jeff. Okay,
didn't
Jeff.
Didn't you do Tradio?
Yeah, we did some years back.
But that was you, right? That was MC for that?
Not really, but... first of all, let me ask you this, Jeff. Did you like it?
I loved it. There was never any dead time.
Then I'm your guy. You got something you want to trade?
Yeah.
What?
His wife. A lightning bolt surfboard.
Lightning
bolt surfboard.
Where do you find that?
In his garage. In Hawaii.
Well, how are you going to trade it if it's in Hawaii?
Oh, no, I brought it back from Hawaii.
Oh, okay.
All right. At the time, they were free. You know, you didn't cost you anything to transport them on the airplane.
Oh, okay.
That was one of the bennies.
So, now explain how this works. You give us the lightning bolt surfboard. And
no given lightning bolt.
You want
cash
us to?
Cash is king, you know.
Okay, all right. This is a surfboard, right? All right.
Right.
So you want us to sell this for you?
We're supposed to trade for something else.
Not really. I've got it on the wall. It's a Jerry Cruise.
Okay.
All right.
How much we asking? How much we asking, Jeff?
I was asking $2,000.
All right. Well, we'll see if a caller. We'll see if we got, we had another caller, but
or best offer.
Well,
or best
they heard 2,000 and they hung
yeah,
up.
They hung up. You know, it reminded me of my neighbor across the street. He was going to get rid of his TV, so he put a sign on the parkway on the TV and just put free for the taking. You know, nobody took it. And I suggested the next day he put a sign, $50, gone in 24 hours.
Yep.
Isn't that something?
So, how big is this surfboard? Lightning?
Well, that's what they say. Money talks, and you know,
other stuff walks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, what's the normal commission? If we get $2,000, what do we get out of this? Other than the fact that you're going to say we're a mighty nice show.
Well, I'll keep calling your show and promoting you.
What's the second offer, Jeff?
The second one is, I'll give you a couple bucks.
Okay, so we're looking 2,000. We're going 2,000, a couple bucks to best offer.
Right.
How long you been in sales, Jeff?
Too long.
2,000, a couple bucks. I'm going to write this down. And a best offer. All right, well, we'll see what we can do.
Okay, buddy.
All right, thanks.
All right.
Okay.
Tradio.
That's Jim Selovich.
It's Jim Selovich when you need him.
Yeah.
All right.
That had to be, we've been here 3 years in November. I think he was gone 2 years before we got here. So
yep. Yeah, hey, they got one on eBay. $2,000.
No kidding. Well, there you go. So it's legit. Well, if somebody wants to buy this thing, $2,000 is the offer. That's what he's asking.
Yep.
Or give us a couple bucks, or give us the best offer, 262-694-1050. It's not really the... Well, if somebody wants to call, go ahead. I don't care. All right, now where was I at here? Oh, I got to finish reading the boathouse.
The boathouse.
Yeah. Hey, look, boys and girls.
Hey.
The clock on the wall says it's 11:20, and everybody knows what that means. It's time for all our listeners to strut their stuff and try to stump the chumps. Sponsored by the American Legion Post 21, 504 58th Street here in Kenosha. If you're successful stumping the chumps, you'll win two free fish dinners served the first Friday, and it will have to be the first Friday in September because they are in August. They are undergoing some renovations. And to be eligible, no one from your household could have won any contest within the last 60 days. And it's a huge opportunity for our audience to bring something of intelligence, sophistication, unlike what you're listening to for the last 90 minutes. And what we're going to do is take your, you have a trivia question to ask us, or a trivia question or a song title, and you got to know the answers to these. And who's stumping who the chumps are today is Elmo. Spider Ron, you want in on this?
Yeah.
Yep. And, of course, the man with all the education,
right.
Wacky Wayne, and then there's me. With no education. So if you want to take a chance on stumping the chumps, give us a call. If you want to, there you go. It'll kill some time.
Oh.
If you have a, still have a comment that you want to play Stump the Chumps, if you have a comment about Foxconn, and what you think it's going to be good or bad, I think it's going to be good. I mean, we're going to have, but we don't have 10,000 people. That, all these people supposedly are going to have to come from someplace.
That's right.
And it's going to cause a housing boom, I think, we've never seen before. And anybody that's got any kind of land that's, out in Summers, I don't think Pleasant Prairie has too much land left for housing development. I think most of theirs is in business parks, isn't it? There might be...
But that's under the impression that 10,000 people move here. You still got to figure people are going to commute from wherever they do live.
Well, that's
you're going to get a good portion of that from commuting.
Because our biggest employer right now in Kenosha is Abbott. And I think 6,000 people leave here every day to go down to work at Abbott Park. Mm-hmm. And we also have a total of about, the last I saw, was about 30,000 thereabouts that actually leave Kenosha, the city and the county, to go work elsewhere.
Bedroom community.
Bedroom community.
Wasn't it? In the paper, the old Chrysler plant where they're leveling it, and that said it might be used for.
Was talking about the Chrysler plant, which is 100, and I don't think that's big enough for what they want to do.
That's where the Chinese sex robot factory is going to go. So,
we're working on that. Well, you know, the old Chrysler site is first of all, I don't think it's big enough for what they want to do. Even if they did put something there, it's going to cause. What's going to be the road, the street, 52nd Street? It's going to bring all these people in and out, and 52nd Street's all screwed up as it is, because when one person makes a left-hand turn going east or west, you're backing 10 cars up, and eventually I think they're going to have to put a lot of no left-hand turns, otherwise you're going to have people backed up on 52nd Street. Good morning on Kenosha today.
Good morning. We got a stump question.
You do?
Sure.
Go ahead. Hang on. Where's my sheet here? I had a sheet here. Okay, here it is. Who's this, by the way?
This is Bob from Kenosha.
Bob. Okay, now, Bob, do you go by Bobby or Robert or Boo Boo?
The old crow.
The old crow. Okay. Bob, you've called. You stumped us before, haven't you?
Whiskey, yeah.
Yeah. Okay, Bob.
I may be a day or two off of 2 months, so.
Don't worry about it. We'll round off.
Okay.
All right, do you have a question?
When JFK was running for president, who was his major competitor, Democratic competitor?
Marilyn Monroe.
No, it wasn't Marilyn Monroe. Marilyn Monroe, don't count that. We didn't. Yeah. That was just a throw out. Yeah. Who did he run in the primary?
Yeah.
JFK, who? I should know that. I forgot. The Democrat? Hang on. Give us a second. Wayne, do you know that?
Oh, no. I got nothing on that one.
I think it's... I'm taking a wild guess. Was it... No, we don't use... We don't have the computers over here.
No, we don't use that.
Can see it on television.
You got any 11-year-old grandkids that can help you?
Yeah. Sadly, I got a couple of them.
Wild guess. Adlai Stevenson.
What about Hubert Humphrey?
What about him?
I thought he ran against...
Well, he later, but yeah.
He later ran against Nixon, didn't he?
Right. Well, he got the nomination.
Nixon beat him, didn't he?
Yeah.
Hubert was running against JFK at the very beginning, when JFK first started to run.
Well, you were successful, Bob.
Double check it.
We had a bad one two weeks ago.
Yeah, I kind of gave the farm away, but... Humphrey, that's right, Kennedy would have beat
Triple
him,
H.
And then 4 years later, Humphrey lost to Nixon,
mm-hmm.
correct?
Yeah.
In 68.
Eight years later,
okay. Yep.
I had the opportunity of seeing both of them in person doing their campaigning.
Well, Hubert Humphrey didn't seem to be, I mean, John Kennedy at the time was only 41. 42?
Yeah, right.
And he had a little more charisma than Hubert Humphrey, didn't he?
Yes, and also when he came to speak, this is up in Eau Claire at the college, two state troopers, 4 big black limos, and 2 state troopers drove up, from Milwaukee.
That was it?
And mm-hmm. so, he had a little bit of an accompaniment. But when Hubert Humphrey came there to speak, I think he drove himself down.
Yeah. He came by Uber driver.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hey, Bob, what do you think, as long as you're talking politics, what do you think about Ryan Priebus being thrown under the bus?
I'm quite upset by the Scaramucci rant and rave and foul mouth.
Yeah, you got something to say. I mean, they're all on the same team, but to do that,
you know,
like I said before, every little elementary school kid can start using that stuff and say, hey, the president's boy is doing this, so why can't I talk that way?
Right.
That's exactly the problem I have with it. That's going to be taught in school for years to come.
What do you think about, so now that Ryan Priebus is gone, you think he's got a better future either on CNN or some network television or even working.
Well, I don't think he's going to be on CNN.
Well, I mean, no. I was just a talk show type of thing,
right.
Political.
I'm not sure.
He's been in the studio.
He's a pretty sharp guy. I've met him and talked to him a number of times. He's a pretty sharp guy.
Oh yeah.
And attorney and. So he may go back into the law practice.
Well,
I don't think he's going to have a problem getting a job. Let's put it that way.
But
he's not going to be filing for unemployment anytime soon.
But like Elmo pointed out earlier, that it's been a grind for him for a couple years, and he orchestrated the strategy. And we talked to him. I think it was about a year ago when he was back here in Summers. He actually called us from his garage. I don't know what that was about, but
maybe he keeps his pipe in the garage.
Talked about 12 minutes. He's telling, "Don't tell my wife I'm talking to you guys." Well, all right. So, but he's a bright guy, and he just needs to take a little time off. And I don't think the time is going to be all of that lengthy. So, well, Bob, you stumped us, and off the air, Wacky Wayne is going to get your last name and address, phone number, and I'm going to send you this. Certificate out, but you can't use it till after September 1st for the fish dinners. But
I appreciate it.
All right. Well, thanks for calling, Bob.
Okay. Good talking. Right,
well, you're doing that, Wayne. I'm going to read a sponsor here.
Sure to nominate him for best of Kenosha
and
fish fry, Bloody Marys, music venue, and
oh yes. Speaking of music, Frankie Faldoodle and his Patio Daddios
tonight. Yep.
Who's Mark? Well, that's the name of his band. And Mark Wydra is playing with him. You know, we talk about things to do in Kenosha.
Man, there's opposite.
Man, you got Taste of Wisconsin, where our buddy Pat Garrett's going to be playing at 3 o'clock. And then also you have the Crawford Jazz Band is playing at 2.
Trixie's playing with them.
Trixie's playing.
Yep.
Yep.
And then you have St. Mary's Festival is going on. And then you got the car show at Kennedy Park, right?
Yep.
And so then going to next week, St. Peter's Festival. And that goes for Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Yep. And the week after that is Holy Rosary Festival. Yep. That goes Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. And then you've got the grill games coming up, mm-hmm. along with your birthday, but everything, the town shuts down for that.
For that, yep.
Are those Russian gals coming?
I can work on that.
Okay. And then it leads us up to, let's see, the grill games, and then we got the Labor Day, and summer's Kaputsky.
Yeah.
Kaputsky. Kaputsky.
St. Elizabeth, they usually have one in September.
St. Elizabeth, they have in September?
Yeah, they
Yeah, they moved, used to be 4th of July.
Yeah, so. Yeah, they moved.
Oh, and then also on Labor Day weekend is... Frank Carmichael's Cheesapalooza.
Yep.
So if you can, if you say nothing's going on in this town, you're missing the boat. And then you also got the Wisconsin State Fair.
Yep.
Coming up, starts next Thursday, goes for 10 days. The county fair's after that. And then there's something else. Oh, the county fair's, that's the $9 thing where our friend Mike Bjorn goes all the time. I had to throw that in there. And hopefully we'll see Father Marcus next week. He was well, he had some issues with his house, and the sump pump wasn't put in, so he got that corrected. Now he's up chasing bears, so he says, up in
Managua.
In Managua.
Oh, geez, that's a madhouse up there.
We're going to take our last break, and then we'll get back with High Five Zingers and Doofuses. Running down the home stretch, if you just joined us, this is the July 29th edition of the Kenosha City Weekly Report, coming to you live from Studio A and streaming worldwide here on AM 1050 WIP. Being brought to you by our major sponsors, the Boathouse Pub and Eatery and the legendary Brat Stop, along with a host of many other very fine local businesses. This morning's cast of characters, Elmo Schneider, and from another galaxy called Spiderdome, our video coordinator, Spider Ronnie, the camera dude. Dude. Along with engineer, Wacky Wayne. Round out a very distinguished panel of the most mature guys I've ever come across. We are here each and every Saturday morning from 10 a.m. until noon. If you happen to miss our Saturday show, you can tune in AM 1050 WIP tomorrow, Sunday at noon, and listen to the replay of this morning's broadcast. Oh, you had to do that.
Yeah, you tried to skip it earlier.
What are you, in withdrawals over there?
I'm getting twitchy.
Twitchy.
Call Shirley.
Yeah. Let's try this one. Good morning. You're in Kenosha today. Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, who's this?
This is Marilyn.
Yes, Marilyn. What can we do for you?
I'm going back one of your stories or two about Sandwich, Massachusetts.
Yeah, I got it right here.
Yep, that's the most famous tourist attraction.
No kidding.
In town. Yeah. No. Really?
What, the drunken topless woman of the night? Or what?
How, have you been there?
About 10 times.
Well, we're in Massachusetts, is this? I mean, Massachusetts.
Right off, when you leave the Cape, when you leave Cape Cod,
yeah.
and go back into Boston,
okay.
it's in between there.
Oh, that's why they call it Sandwich, probably, right?
Mm-hmm. That's why it's Sandwich. It's very popular.
Oh,
Sandwich. It's the tourist trade.
Did they invent the sandwich there, or is it?
Yes, I told you I'm a tour guide.
What kind of sandwich was it?
Well, some
pastrami on rye,
peanut butter and jelly. What do we got here?
But you know what? So for all of those, what's the population of sandwich? Probably something under 3 million. So
what's the population? I have no idea.
Okay, but it's probably something under 3 million, wouldn't you suspect?
What?
It's. I'm guessing that the population of Sandwich, Massachusetts. Okay, 20,000. Thanks, Spider.
675.
And
yeah,
Okay, that's some 20,000 is something under 3 million. Anyway, they're mighty. All 25,000 are probably very proud of the Susan Kettle, who's.
Oh, they certainly are.
And
right into there's a lot of Kennedy attractions also.
Oh, okay. Well, this gal, the picture of her. They're very pleasant looking. I don't know.
I can't imagine anybody going down the street. Well, the little winding roads all over.
Well, she got into this thing. Apparently, she was intoxicated. A drunken woman. Can you believe that? Takes her shirt off. Boy, you just hate to see that happen.
Well, that was a major attraction there. Trust me.
Yeah, I imagine. made the internet, right?
Yeah. So. Major. Major.
So yeah. What else you got going on in Marilyn's life these days?
Right now I'm going down to the show on Peoria Park.
The car show.
With all the car show.
Oh, yeah.
My son is selling some goodies there.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
They got about 1,000 cars, if not more, down there, don't they?
Oh, the people. They're from all over the country.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's good for Kenosha. In fact, coming up on Labor Day, you know, they have that, Tony Pontillo has it down on 6th Avenue, which they're expecting 2,000 cars. And the issue is 6th Avenue going to be done by then? And I don't know how
is
they're going
to be. I don't think it's going to be done.
The mayor is promising it's going
to
be done.
Because otherwise, the option was to go, like, from 50, where City Hall is, and go north up to 7th Avenue, past...
that would be ideal.
You could go right up past Captain Mike's there and Carlville de Carlos.
And Boathouse,
and you could go, then you also go right up to the, have the bands playing in the Union Park there. Mm-hmm. I mean, it'd be ideal. But
there you go.
They said...
That would be a plan.
Well, that was my suggestion, but I'm not the mayor.
You're not the mayor.
Anymore.
Twice failed, Mayor.
Oh, I knew this was coming
up. You're not the mayor anymore. Yeah,
right. Okay.
Well,
go ahead.
I wish I had a car in that show. Had one, but let it go.
What year?
1929 Nash.
Ooh,
sweet.
You're right.
I
wish I could find it now.
How much did you sell it for?
Oh, I don't know. It was a good deal.
Probably was a...
At the time, it was a policeman bought it, Roger Funk.
Oh, okay. Well, it's probably worth a great deal of money now, 1929. Probably all restored and...
Mm-hmm. Oh, my other cars are in the museum, Ford Museum in Michigan.
Oh, okay. Well, you get all over there, Marilyn.
Yeah.
We're mighty proud of you.
Sandwich?
Yeah.
Michigan?
Sandwich? Yeah. Cape Cod?
What do you think of...
You name it, I've been there.
What do you think of our boy, Ryan Priebus, getting thrown under the...
I'm sad.
Trump,
I'm very sad about that.
Yeah, a lot of people are upset.
He's a brilliant young man.
Yeah, everybody's all agreed there. Where do you think he's going to end up? On a talk show or...
Not on this one.
Not on this one. On purpose.
not on your... Well, hey, don't laugh. He might just be there.
Well, you know what, though? Seriously, Steve Casey and I talked to him. He was back in Summers last September. And he called us, and we talked to him for about 12 minutes. And so I guess he thought he called the wrong number at the time.
I don't think so. He's a very smart man.
Yeah.
Yep.
He made the right move.
Oh, yeah. Why do you want to put up... In fact, I'm going to address that here in doofuses and that.
Hey.
Well, you put up with those characters, so...
Oh, no. I commend him. I support him. Whatever he's doing, fine.
Very good, Marilyn. Well, thank you for the call.
You're very welcome. Next time I go to Sandwich, I'll pick you up.
Okay.
Have a great day.
And don't go get again any road rage incidents where you take your shirt off.
I'm on a deluxe motor coach.
Okay. Okay. Oh, okay. All right, Marilyn. Later.
See you later. Right. Bye.
Also, the status of the Secret Word Challenge to win $25 gift certificate to Mike Bjorn's Clothing here in hot, hot, hot downtown Kenosha. I just took that right off.
Yeah, I know. It's fine. Yeah, we won't hit the button. It's okay.
Here's a hint. It's four syllables. A complex word.
Yes. Offering the largest selection of men's suits in all of southeast Wisconsin and northern Illinois for only $179. You can find them on Facebook or call them at 262-652-0648. And now, boys and girls, it's time for this week's edition of As the Brat Turns, High Five Singers and Doofuses. Coming to us from the Beer Garden in the world and famous and legendary Brat Stop, located on the northwest corner of Highways 50 and I-94 here in Kenosha. Open at 8 a.m. 7 days a week, 365 days a year, serving breakfast, lunch, dinner, and everything in between. For more information on what's going on at the Brat, call them at 262-857-2011. As the Brat turns, like the sands in the hourglass in the days of our lives. Boy, that sounded like a moan.
Yeah, well.
All right, this week's high five goes to... Kenosha County Deputy Friendly Ray Rowe for being named the state of Wisconsin's DARE Officer of the Year. Ray began teaching DARE drug abuse resistance education in Kenosha City and County Schools in 2001. The DARE curriculum teaches safe and responsible decision-making and provides children with the skills to resist drug and alcohol abuse. And God knows with the heroin epidemic all across the country, his talents are needed more now than ever before. Plus, Ray runs also the best golf outing. The DARE golf outing is this fundraiser, which is, by the way, next Wednesday, and I'm doing my best not to get hurt myself or hurt anybody else. So to Deputy Ray Rowe, we thank you and give you a very high five. This week's zinger goes to President Donald Trump for throwing our guy Reince Priebus under the trolley, so to speak, leaving Reince with basically no other option than to resign as the White House Chief of Staff. It's very apparent that the wheels are coming off this administration, along with the failed health care bill to repeal and replace Obamacare, all the turmoil going on with the FBI and the CIA. Hey, don't forget the Russians.
That's right.
We got them to deal with. And I don't think Reince handled, I do think that Reince handled all this nonsense with his usual professional style and grace, and once all said and done and the smoke clears, honestly, I think Mr. Priebus will be a whole lot better off than having to deal with these characters. This week's Doofus Award goes to President Trump's newly appointed Communications Director, Anthony Scaramucci, for referring to Reince Priebus as a leaker. Apparently, in an interview with CNN, Mr. Scaramucci, even dropped an F-bomb, accusing Reince of being a paranoid schizophrenic. We say, back off, chump. Leave our boy from Summers alone. We like him. If you want to pick on somebody, we have a former Kenosha alderman who's now living in Summers. You can use all your colorful language with that guy. You want to hear a peep out of me? I got to calm down. I got to calm down. And there you have it, folks. That's the Pratt Turns for this Saturday, July 29th, 2017. I'm Scotty Barger, and I approve this message. Atta boy, Spider. Jeez. What was going on over there? I see the curtain waffling.
Don't stop.
We have just a few minutes left here. What's he doing?
You don't want to know.
Don't stop.
You don't want to know.
If you want to. You don't want to know.
Where's Captain Mike when you need him?
Huh? Yeah.
I know nothing.
I'm surprised. I never heard of Sandwich. Listen to him.
There was a Sandwich, Illinois, too.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I had a friend from there.
We're trying to help Jeff. I think he's from, Jeff says he's from Kenosha Racine. He's got a lightning bolt surfboard. We're going to try to help him sell that thing. He wants $2,000, a couple bucks, or best offer. If you want to call in, maybe we can connect on that deal. And we talked about that. And if you want to talk about calling the Kenosha News, or you have to go to Colleen Myers at cmyers@kenoshanews.com and vote for your favorite auto body, best auto, best education, best food and spirits, best health and beauty. We won't be winning because there is not a category
of shows
that suck big time. What's that?
Worst radio show.
The worst radio show. We don't have a category. Let's see. We talked about the dogs in Harbor Market, or if they should do that. We talked about that. We're almost to the end. I'm out of. If you think you want to put a microchip on somebody, who would that be? This could be. This is not a good deal for guys that are married. I can't see this.
Nope. Even if they're not.
Even if they're not married, I mean this could put cheating to an all time low. How? But there, you know what? As soon as you put a chip in. How are they going to do this? Are they going to put an incision and put this under your skin?
No, it's like a hypodermic needle.
Oh,
and it's like getting a flu shot that just poof, and it goes.
But it's
in
there. How do you take it out?
That takes surgery.
Oh, so they got poor guys coming and going. That's Wayne. Well, it's a different world.
You know what they're talking about, using those instead of ankle bracelets.
Oh, that
if you're, if you're under house arrest. Yeah. So.
Good morning. You're on Kenosha Today. Hello.
Hey, morning. How are we doing, you gentlemen?
Well, Mr. Rosenberg, I presume.
Yep.
Maybe.
What's up?
I just wanted to let everybody know in the 8th District that the final deadline for applications for anybody who wants to fill the vacated seat is this next Friday, August 4th, by 4:30.
Do you know of anybody, can you tell, that's already applied?
There's been a couple people apply already.
Okay. Now, so Everybody says Matheson is history. So now it's up to the city council, correct me if I misstate something, to decide, one, you can let it go vacant, right? That's one option.
Right.
Two, you can have a special election is the second option. Or three, you choose.
Council
will choose, not the mayor, correct?
Correct.
Okay. So that's it. You have a meeting, you don't have a meeting this week.
No, it'll be August 7th where all the applicants, right now there's two, or and then any others that come in this next week will come before us on August 7th, and then from there we will decide to choose one of them or one of the other options.
There you go. Now, for those that, my cousin Vinny lives underneath the 50th Street Bridge, and he's going to apply this next week, because if he gets selected and you guys give him that honor of being Alderman of the 8th District, he's got 30 days to move in, correct?
I believe so.
So, Shirley lives in the 8th District. I can see this as a match made in heaven. Just my cousin Vinny moves in with Shirley.
Now, Keith, does this work like American Idol? Do they have to sing up in front of the city council in order to pick the best one out of that?
No. They actually submit to, with their application, basically a resume of their job history and why they basically have state to us why they want to be the alderman of the 8th district, and then we basically look at all that information, listen to their pitch to us, and then choose the best candidate.
Now, do you have to figure out one of those three options prior, or can you listen to their pitch and then decide, well, I didn't like any of the candidates, we'll leave it vacant, or come to the other options? Or do you have to pick one of the options before you get to that?
Right.
Okay. Now, one of the your colleagues, the alderman from the 4th, suggested, I heard him, that he wants a caretaker, and say, I don't want somebody that's going to be an alderman and run in the spring. Now, I don't know what's anybody else's feelings, but if we go to all our current judges, I think pretty much all of them were appointed for some whatever reasons by the governor, and then yes, they ran, when their terms came up. And yeah, it gives them, does it give them an unfair advantage because of being an incumbent?
I suppose. It gives them a leg up, I think, in anything.
Yeah, so
it does.
What?
Yep. Name recognition.
So I think you're going to hear some debate on using that as an issue.
Well, I just look at who's going to be the best qualified candidate, because we are coming up on budgets, for next year, and who's going to be best suited to represent the 8th district. That's what it comes down to, bottom line.
You really can't.
Whether that person's running again or not is irrelevant to me.
Right. I don't know.
Best candidate.
I really can't imagine how you could say, I'm going to select my cousin Vinny, with the understanding of Vinny, you got to sign off and say, I'm not running in the spring. Well, Vinny could say, forget it. There's no law that says I can't.
Right.
So.
Correct. You're just taking that as somebody's word they're not going to run. It's a process, and we have to go through it, and hopefully select the best candidate.
Well, just so you know that Vinny is a pretty sharp guy, and I homeschooled him in the issues of politics. I taught him everything he knows about politics.
Well, that's not much.
Oh, come on. He's not a two-time loser.
Well, that's true.
Unlike some people, you know. Okay.
And if you don't pick him, that's not going to count as a blemish against his, because he could run in another district somebody else decides to leave the council.
Yeah, but on another subject, on Mr. Priebus, I think he got out while the getting's good.
Oh, I agree. So,
I agree.
Yeah.
Because
I think
It's getting ready to implode.
Yes, the wheels are coming off. I'm disappointed because Trump sold a bill of goods to this country, and it sounded like it was doing pretty good, but he hasn't gotten anything done. So.